Hey, it's Yuri Experience, and today we are talking about patterns. It's Yuri Experience. Today we have a next video about style basics, and if you haven't watched the previous ones, I would recommend you to do that prior watching this video. From time to time I will tell something like, and that we discussed in previous video, or and that we discussed in the video about contrasts. All the links are in description, so please watch the videos first prior to watching this video so you know what I'm talking about. And today we are discussing patterns. There is a lot of information that is out there about patterns, and I will definitely forget something when I will talk about that today. But if that happens, it happens. I will just cover that in a different video at some point in my life where I will decide, oh, by the way, I forgot that, that, and that. So what are patterns? Basically, if you have different colors in the same piece of clothing and it doesn't come from the material, then you have a pattern. That is why this is almost not a pattern, that is just like material goes. And this is definitely a pattern. There are some rules and some information about patterns that I want to share with you, and we start with the lines. I assume you know what the line means. I mean, I'm wearing a t-shirt that has horizontal lines. There is a lot of information and rules about patterns, however, all of them are based on the fact that eyes of people are looking on the contrast. For example, my t-shirt, we have a contrast of dark blue and some bluish white, which makes our eyes unconsciously go from side to side because we go along the lines. And the same with all the patterns. When our eyes are looking on the patterns, we recognize contrast and we are following the pattern. Why? Because contrasts bring our attention, and that's what we talked about in a contrast video. Let's start with an easy part. Lines. We have vertical and horizontal lines normally, there are also diagonal lines, but they're not that common in men's clothing. Vertical lines make you appear taller and slimmer. On the other hand, horizontal lines make you look slightly broader and shorter. So at the end of the day, the question is what you try to achieve and what you want to bring attention of other people to. For example, if you're a really tall person, then it would be not the best idea to make you look even taller. If you have a bigger tummy and you want to hide it kind of, then it wouldn't be the best idea to wear horizontal lines. Me, for example, I do like to appear slightly broader. That is why I do like to wear horizontal lines, but I'm not tall enough and not slim enough to not wear vertical lines at all. Still, I don't have any vertical lines in my casual wear. I do have some in my formal wear, but not even one in my casual wear. By the way, normally the broader are the lines, the more casual is the piece of clothing. And from the lines we go to all other possible patterns. We have checks, which is like horizontal line, and vertical line, which make kind of square. We have polka dots, so like dots. We have some floral patterns and some patterns that are called after some fangs. And also there are patterns that you cannot see from a distance, but you can see if you come closer. Anyway, there are a lot of patterns. All of them are attention picker. So if you are wearing them, you are bringing attention to that piece of clothes. The stronger is the contrast between the color of the pattern and the background color, the more casual is normally this piece of clothing. Good example here would be flannels, where you have like really big squares, and it's a typical casual piece of clothing. Even if you would take the same pattern and make more of a formal shirt, this still wouldn't be really formal. It would be difficult to wear it with a suit, for example. How to bring patterns to your wardrobe? Here, the best example would be start small. Start with something that you are more or less comfortable wearing and what you think really looks good on you and what you like. Here, kind of the bad thing I can recommend you would be socks, because socks is almost the only thing that you wear both in casual and in formal wear. And you can have a lot of fun there. You can have polka dots, you can have lines, you can have different floral aesthetics or some different colors. And when you get used to picking the pattern to your clothing, then go slightly bigger. Then I would say pick a t-shirt with horizontal lines or vertical lines. I think lines are like the easiest pattern to start with, which is why I'm a big fan of lines. And from there you can go to different kind of patterns. Also, I wouldn't recommend to mix more than one pattern, at least at the beginning when you are not used to that. Take pieces of clothes that have one color and add one piece of clothing that has some pattern on it. It will make you look more interesting. And when you are choosing this piece of clothing, still think about the rules that I've told you about in previous videos about color matching. It is not recommended to match your colors perfectly, like have some blue kind of pattern and the same blue kind of jeans. But if you have some dark blue jeans and other shade of blue t-shirt with some lines, for example white lines, then you can do literally nothing wrong. By the way, that's what I'm wearing right now. And when you get comfortable with wearing patterns, with choosing a piece of clothes with some patterns that can match different pieces of clothes, you can try to mix different patterns. Here my best advice would be choose different kinds of patterns. Even here you try to create contrast. You will choose one pattern with slimmer lines or smaller dots and one pattern with bigger lines or bigger dots or like bigger things like floral pieces. That will allow you to look like you thought it through but didn't think too much and just combined two strange pieces. Patterns is not the easiest topic. It's something that you need to get used to. It's something that you need to get comfortable with and what you need to enjoy wearing. In my personal opinion, patterns make you look even better than you look without patterns, if it makes sense. Everything here is about attention, about getting attention, about bringing it to right parts of your body. And patterns will only help you with that. That is kinda it for today. I hope it was informative. It was kinda big topic. If you enjoyed the video, drop a like and subscribe to the channel. I do daily videos about different topics and tomorrow will be some grooming video. Which one? I'm not sure. And if you have any questions about patterns or about style or about something else, write them in the comments below and I will answer these questions in the comments or in a different video or I will read about that. I do not know everything. But I do know a lot. That's all for today, and I'll see you tomorrow.